see the little guy growing out. Isn't that cool? So that all of a sudden you can put all these different things together. And that is exactly what happens with us. Our rotten selves get cut off from God. We covered that part already. But then, now here's the thing. We're down here on the ground. We can't just be grafted in just right away. Our sins had to be forgiven. So Jesus comes and he dies. And he gets rid of all the sins. He takes them on to himself. And now our sins are forgiven. But here's a question for you. When Jesus died on the cross, how many sins of the world did he die for? Did he die for all of them or just the Christian sins? Think about that. So did he just die for my sins and your sins, or did he die for Adolf Hitler's sins? You know, he's a pretty bad guy. Did Hitler's sins go to the cross? Yes, they did. Yes, they did go to the cross. So then that leads us to a next question. Well, then if Hitler's sins were forgiven, then why is, you know, I'm assuming he's not going to be in heaven. You know, if Hitler's sins are forgiven, then is he going to be in heaven? Well, here's the thing. He died for all the sins, but that's where we still are. We're still on the ground. I'm on the ground. Hitler's on the ground. Everybody's on the ground. And that's where God, the Master Gardener, has to come in and pick us up and graft us back in. And he makes all those cuts like you saw, and we go. It's that graft that saves us. We wouldn't have gotten grafted in had the sins still been there. So the sins got removed, and then we get grafted back in. It's being here, and all of this sap that flows up. Last week, we saw that those baptisms happening right here with this water here. That water from baptism flows up it. Flows up us, and flows up through Christ into us. Baptism, it saves us, and it brings us closer to God. It had the opposite effect on Jesus. Jesus, because of having to take all our sins onto himself and becoming a person, that those baptismal waters that we share that cleaned us ultimately made him dirty. It sent him away from God and made him sinful. But because of that baptism, we got clean. And that water nourishes us. The water nourishes us in baptism, and in the sacrament of Holy Communion, that blood of Christ, and it's being connected to that blood of Christ, that nourishes us. Here, this was, I think, the gospel reading, or if not, it sure sounds like it, but I am the vine, you are the branches. This was also in my wedding verse of Mrs. Blank there. But if we are in him, we produce fruit. And we could not produce fruit without that life-nourishing sap that comes up us. And then you can read the gold parts there. But now I want to show you this tree. I like this tree. This tree is a fruit cocktail tree or a fruit salad tree. And you can buy these. You just got to ask at the nursery for them. Maybe you have one. I don't know. But a tree that can produce multiple fruits. Because if you're grafting one type, why not keep going and graft on, you know, hey, I got an orange tree, I put a lemon tree on, and I put a grapefruit on it, and I put a this on it, and that, and before you know, I got this orange and that orange. You can do that. And then this verse here, for just as the body is one and has many members, see, we have one plant, many parts, and all the members of the body, though many, are one body, so it is with Christ. For in one spirit we are all baptized into one body. It is the same water that courses through us. Jews or Greeks, that's everyone. Slaves or free, that's another way of saying everyone. And all were made to drink of one spirit. We drink up that water of Christ through that graft. When you are having a rough day, I want you to think about that graft. That's what faith is. Faith is knowing. Faith is seeing that graft. Whether you see it or not, that graft is there. God put it there. If you have a weak faith, you don't see it well. If you have a strong faith, you see that graft real well. When you have a hard time, things aren't going so hot, look at that graft as hard as you can. And that will give you strength because that's where your source comes from. That's where how you are connected to Christ. See all those plants. And now look at this guy. This guy has over 250 types of apples grown on that tree. And think of the Father as the gardener. Now, that guy is not actually God. He's a man. But think of that. That's what God's doing. He's cutting us into the plant. He's taken up these branches that would die if they just left here, or left here, and he puts them in. Jesus is that root that sucks up all of that nourishment and brings it to us. We are grafted into the tree, and then what do? When we're grafted in, as my brother said, he said, you know, that all of the genetic material is in that bud. It's already pre-programmed in there. It's ready to produce fruit. I don't have to go to an apple tree and tell my apple tree, produce apples this spring. It's going to do it. It's programmed into it. I could tell it to, but it's just going to do it whether I tell it to or not, because that's what plants do. They're pre-programmed to do it. And then this tree here, I want to make sure I get all the, I wrote it down. This tree is what happened last week in our baptisms. This tree is how we hear when we hear the word in chapel every week. And this tree, we lean on that graft, and we are nourished through that graft and that union. That tree is God, and that tree is us. Thank you very much.